Ryan, thank God you're here. Are you okay?
No! Nothing is okay! They abducted Henry. I have to find a way inside that UFO. Meanwhile, I've been trying to get to Brandon's house because he's in trouble too.
We'll help you, Ryan. The cars don't drive anymore, but maybe this old biplane does. We could use the biplane to get near the UFO.
That seems like a long shot. But I guess it's our only option. But even if we do get close, how the hell are we gonna get inside of that thing?
I don't know. Maybe Matt has a solution for that. He is on the farm to get some stuff. Can you tell him that the biplane is almost repaired?
All right. And by the way, that officer you called? They got him. They imprisoned him in a barn somewhere around town. I also found some odd documents about Greyhill in a squad car.
I never call the police. Brandon forbid that.
Yeah? But I thought you don't listen to our chief.
Usually I don't listen to him. This time I did. But who called him then?
I don't know. I'll go talk to Matt now.
Ryan, we'll find a solution to rescue Henry.
Matt, is that you?
Hello? Hello? Help! I'm locked in here!
Matt! What are you doing in there?
Aliens came and I hid in the safe and now I'm locked in here.
Oh shit! Okay, I don't know the code, but I'll look for it, so just hang on.
Wait. Ryan, you don't think that they, you know, probe us when we become abducted?
What? I don't know, man. They abducted Henry. I'm trying not to think about that right now. Just hang on and let me get you out of there.
Oh, Ryan. We'll help you. Please. Please look for the code. My back hurts already. But make sure the Greys don't follow you into this room. Otherwise, you have to lure them away.
Okay. All right. I'm gonna go talk to Amy about our plan to rescue your son. Can you go and search for a barrel of kerosene and bring it to the barn gate?
Yeah, I'll go find one. You just better have that plane ready. Okay, let's bring it to the barn door. Huh? Apone! I can hear you! What happened?
I'm not sure. I can't think straight. They cut me. Bad. I think I got away before they could finish. They put something in me. It's cold to the touch. Some kind of metal, maybe. I'm almost at the church. Can you see it? Meet me inside. We need to talk about next steps.
All right, I'll be right there.
And I looked, and behold, a stormy wind came out of the north, a great cloud with a fire enfolding itself, and a brightness round about it. And out of the mist thereof, as if it were glowing metal, out of the mist of the fire, and out of the mist thereof came the likeness of four living creatures. and this was their appearance. They had the likeness of a man.
Father Grant,
and everyone
Father Grant,
had Ryan. Don't you hear that I'm preaching? Stop interrupting me!
Did you see a police officer come through here? His name is Apone.
And you think he can secure you from the angels of God?
Father! Those aren't angels. This is an alien invasion. They abducted my son and I need to save him. Who knows what they're doing to him?
Ryan, he is in God's hands. What do you think would I give that the angels take me? Your son is blessed. It begins. It begins now.
Father!
I'm here!
Ryan, glad to finally meet you. Listen, these motherfuckers, they probed me. It hurts. I can't help you anymore. But here's the number of the man who sent me here. Take it.
They took my son! Do you know how to get him back?
Call the number. He'll know what to do. He'll help you find your son. Help you stop this invasion. He's done this before. Don't call anybody else. Not the police. Not the government. They won't help you. Not unless you want to end up in the psych ward if you survive all this. Only trust the man on this number. I never thought I'd die in a goddamn graveyard.
Apone! Apone! Don't die, goddammit! Where the fuck am I gonna find a working phone?
Thank you.
phones are down.